In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make some leaping arches for your next holiday or your next LED project. These are pretty simple to make. I've got 5 in my show. I'm going to add probably another 5 coming up this season. A list of materials that I use. I 3D printed off a couple of bases for this. I've included those in the description down below. I use 1/2 inch EMT conduit and 3/4 inch white PEX tubing. You can get this at any big box stores. So here's our measurements. For the EMT conduit, it's 60 inches across, which is 5 feet, and they can come standard cut to 5 feet there. The arch, I made it 74 inches. You can make yours as tall or as short as you want. I did 74 inches because that is the length of seed pixels that I'm going to be using on the inside of my, inside of the PEX tubing here. And so it just came out to be a nice arch there. If you want to go longer or you want to go taller, it's up to you. You just have to adjust your amount of seed pixels that you're going to use inside here. The seed pixels I'm using are the 5-volt seed pixels. They have a 10 centimeter pitch, which means it's 10 centimeters from pixel to pixel. And so that's when they talk about the pitch, that's the distance between the pixels. And so you can get them tighter, you can get them from 2 centimeters, you can get them 1 centimeter. I found the 10 centimeters is great. I kind of like the old school spacing look. I like the way, I just like the spacing overall. I think it looks a lot better than the dense ones, but to each their own. You can create however you want to. The distance of my arch is exactly 20 seed pixels long. So I've made my controller be able to only light up 20 seed pixels. So when I plug it in, it counts it for me. And I know when the lights are done, that's where the 20th seed pixel is. So I went ahead and cut that. I use all Ray Wu in my shows and in my installs. And so these are Ray Wu pigtails that I'm using here. I like these heat shrink tubings. Some people have great luck with them. Some people don't have good luck with them. I've never had one fail, and I use them all the time. And so these are what I use. Some people like to solder. Again, it's up to you. I've never had one fail. Some people have, so. Right here, I'm testing and making sure that the pass-through is actually working. So I've gotten to my WLED controller. I fired up so it powers up 22 lights. You can see it lights up the next 2 lights in that strand right there so that I know that my tails are good on both sides here. So here's my 3D printed bases. On the bottom, you can see a hole down there. What that is that's going to set the EMT conduit into the bases so it can't move. So it doesn't come out of there. And then on the side there, you can see that's where my cables are going to come in. And that's where the PEX tubing is going to install and my cables come out the side there. Now with the PEX tubing, the Ray Wu connectors fit perfectly down in there. If your connectors don't fit down there, you're going to have to pull your seeds through and then solder it on outside the tube there. I'm a big fan of always labeling because when you make a project and a couple years later, you can't remember what voltage they were, how many lights they were, all that. So I put 5 volts on the end here. In the bottom of the PEX tubing, what I've done is I take some silicone caulking and I fill up that hole right there and basically seal the tube up. Now, it's not watertight seal, but it does help keep water out of it so it doesn't fill it up. Here it is where it's all dried up. And my tail on the end there. So now I'm ready to go ahead and construct and build my leaping arches together. So you see when this piece slides on here, that the cable slides down the side of it and comes out the side and it's great, it's perfect. I don't have to drill another hole. I don't have to figure out how to do cable management. Comes out the side, it's perfect. So I take a self-tapping screw, I go into the base down here, and the first one I'm going to do, it doesn't matter how the orientation of the pipe to the base is, I go ahead and I just set that screw in there, but now I want to make sure that the other one is perfectly square with how I do it. So if you take it, you put it on its side, you grab your other one, put it, it's on its side, now you've got it, them both square to each other. So I know that the base is going to be flat, I'm going to go ahead and set that one. I'm going to install my PEX tubing with my lights in it on one side here. Go ahead and install it on the other side there. And it's wobbling because I have a high part in my carpet. That's why it's wobbling back and forth. But I can assure you that those are square to each other. So this is what it looks out. There's not a left. There's not a right. Those are, you can go either side with those 3D printed parts. I'm going to go ahead and plug it in here. And let's take a look at what it looks like. So here we go. The seed pixels shine right through that PEX tubing. Some people take some alcohol and they clean off all the lettering. I find it doesn't matter. It's going to be out in the middle of the yard. No one sees it. You can see the spacing on mine is a little bit further apart. Again, if you want yours more dense, you can get something with some 5 centimeter pitch or something even smaller and put that in there. But this is just showing you the basics of how to assemble the arch together. Pretty simple, pretty effective piece in the show. I'm running all this through WLED. So they have some presets of some chases, and that's what you're seeing there. Hey, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching. Please like and please subscribe, and I can keep these videos going. And if you have any comments, comment down below.